Hello, welcome to the Stephen Trice podcast, series 3, episode 23.
Whoa!
Who'd have thought it?
This week I'm joined by Ryan Locke.
Ryan!
God, you have had a Red Bull, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Cameron Green.
Hello!
And Max Smith.
Hello there!
He's not had a Red Bull, he's had a protein shake and a tug.
Gonna burn the calorie summer. Ferocious.
Questions for your PT, though. Gotta check your form, man. As you can see, there is a change-up around here. Tom, by his own admission, was pretty poor on recent podcasts. We did do one last week in Ibiza with Tom there, but it was terrible, really blah, and he was on a massive come-down. So we've replaced him with Cameron Green.
Hey.
Famously never on come-downs. Shut up.
Just shut up.
Shut the fuck up.
Put the shades back on. Your pupils are giving you away.
I think I might.
Cameron, you've been away on holiday.
I need another holiday after coming back.
Where'd you go?
Well, Barcelona. But I haven't told you yet.
Nice.
Someone tried to rob me in the street.
Who?
Walking down the road, big bugger with a balloon and a little skinny bugger. Big bugger comes over and goes, my friend, trying to get fucking like Dracula, trying to get me to have some of this balloon. So I went, no, fuck off, mate, fuck off. I ain't finished yet.
Be a better film than it, wouldn't it? Yeah, fuck off. Back in you go to lad.
He's
go
doing
on.
His little dance.
Fuck off, you mate.
Fuck off.
I'm the only one that eats kids around
here. I'm a good boy.
This town ain't big enough for the both of us.
We've not got to the bit how we got robbed yet.
Oh, yeah.
Turn around. Petey, where are you? Flying off with his balloons.
That little boy's mine.
Anyway, the little bugger goes, no, my friend tries to get me to the balloon. It's like 3 or 4 in the morning and it's a dark side street, so I just go, fuck off. And I stick my fists up and think, if he's going to try it on me us here, then I can't run off. I mean, I run in slow motion at the best of times. So then as soon as I put my fists up, the big one walks off and the little one grabs my chain, and it's the chain that my mum gave me dad, so it's very sentimental. Tries to yank it off. I grab his wrist and shove him. And he goes, falls over and runs off. I was really pissed off.
Yeah,
every muggers and people trying to rob you.
Bad for pickpockets.
Everywhere. I didn't think it would be so bad.
Right.
I didn't know it was that. I've been twice. Never had any issues.
Well, you need to have something worth stealing first.
Oh, right, okay, yeah.
Did they pinch the top of your head? It's a bit of a fringe operation they've got going on.
Hey.
Nice.
Yeah.
But,
apart from that, it's nice enough. It's just the night time. It's so dangerous. Makes you think places like Liverpool, where I've never had any trouble.
Yeah.
Really bad rap.
Maybe you just, because you know where to go in Liverpool, maybe you're just in there. Yeah.
Well, that's it. And I think everyone knows me as well.
You know, that's it, in Barcelona.
Do you know not to mess around? Do now.
Easy target.
Do now.
Offer him balloons and he'll go for it.
If you're over 18, you're safe.
Really?
Wow, that's weird.
That was just a bit of a callback.
Well, I don't know. I don't recall anything.
Yeah, what?
Previously.
What are you calling back?
The more I say it, the more I think the police will be the ones calling me back. Have you reported crime? I have. Well, I might got some bad news for you, my friend. Yeah, the plane back as well. We got to the airport 2.5-3 hours early, and then that's delayed for 2.5 hours.
Oh, yeah.
So we're there until daft o'clock at night in this, like, liminal space where everything's turned off in the airport.
So bleak.
There's just one little pub called a healthy food cafe for healthy people. The only thing they sold was litres of Heineken. Which is a picture of health.
Yeah.
And that was a good laugh, to be fair.
There you go.
That's good then.
The highlight was sitting in a dark airport where I felt some modicum of safety.
So what was the highlight, aside from the airport, you
New
know,
Camp.
Boss? You went to the stadium.
Oh, the New Camp was absolutely class. I need to sneeze. You know, I'll just keep going till it comes. we got to go down on the pitch, saw all the Champions League trophies.
Let me guess, they signed you up.
They saw my one
foot. You pinged one in the back of the net.
Fighting spirit. I went down to the pitch, and it was the guy who tried to rob me in a Barcelona suit. And he's like, "That was a test. You passed. In you come. You're the new Chavi."
Chavi.
"I heard you can open a tin of beans with your right foot. I needed to put it to the test."
Just sees a nub instead of a foot.
It's gone wrong recently. I can't lie.
My Inspector Gadget tin opener foot. The rumours were true. Yeah, that was fun. That was the best bit of it. Yeah.
Did you go right to the top?
Yeah, yeah. You got to go all around the stadium. Yeah. Got a picture taken on the pitch with the Champions League trophy.
God, what was that like for you, the first ever turning into
touch him on? Oh, unbelievable. I dreamt about it for years.
Comfort seats as well, where the managers sit.
We sat there. Yeah, yeah.
Really? Everyone else gets shit
wrong. He's not wrong. Well, this guy knows his chairs.
I go to DFS before I go to the ground. Bring my own, comfy chair.
While we were walking around, we did like this pose, one of the photos.
Nice.
At the end of the tour, this guy was like, "I have never seen anybody do that for a photo. You guys are the funniest people ever in Barcelona. Please, do you want a picture of this? It only costs 50 euros. You can buy one for me and I'll keep it for myself. I'll never forget you guys. The funniest people ever in Barcelona."
Yeah, 50 pounds.
So anyway, I'm going on Spanish Live at the Apollo next week. Walking on stage.
You just walk on your chain, gets robbed.
Yeah, that's what you're holding on to.
What the? So there's someone running out with six balloons, Ryan's fringe, and a chain. "You've been punked. I'll got you."
Ryan's fringe.
Did you say El got you?
El got you. Yeah.
God, that culture, you just soaked it all up.
I think the problem was I didn't tell him to El fuck off, so they probably didn't get it.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck off. El fuck off. God.
You, wouldn't you know fuck off from Spain? I thought you knew the rude words.
I think they learned it just to say it to me. Just so I knew they were saying fuck off to me. El fuck off.
Yeah. Hey? Max Smith, what have you been up to?
God, do you know what? I've been doing a lot of stuff that you'd probably find boring.
No, go on.
Looking for an office.
That's not boring.
That's real, you know.
Let's get into this. What sort of office space is Max Smith Industries looking for?
I'm looking for a one-man office, private, with 24/7 access.
Sexist? A one-man office?
Many women.
Oh, ratios.
Yeah. Sick ratio, man. One-person office, shall we say. For me.
Yeah.
Obviously. It would be a bit weird otherwise.
Bit of an office cook, aren't you?
Look at him work.
He's inside it. Look at those spreadsheets.
So one person office, 24/7 access with great Wi-Fi, please.
Yeah.
Found one.
Nice.
Good, check it out on Friday.
Yeah, you don't need a flat now if you've got an office 24/7.
That's it.
The grind starts.
I found one and the guy was like, "It's £700 a month." And I said, "No." And I hung up straight away, so we didn't have that awkwardness afterwards. Then I found a new one, 220. I was like, "Yeah. Please.
220, that's it. I feel like there's going to be a catch here.
I assume so.
Is it going to be one where, because I found one, but there was a gap above and below the door, so you could to the next room. And I was like, I can't do the podcast there because they just hear us saying a lot of bad things.
Specifically about them. Yeah.
Look how ugly his shoes and his great baguette is. It tips over the door. Have we seen both his shoes and his fucking head?
Massively.
Peter Crouch at the door.
Heard you boys are doing a podcast. Fuck off and take Chris Stark with you.
Yeah, love that reference.
Moving on to the Ibiza boys.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Chris was home. He shook his fist forwards and backwards. Yeah. You shared a room with Dave.
I did. Too much.
Shared it too much.
Sharing a room with Dave was very amusing. We were both obviously quite drunk. We came back a lot of nights.
Yeah.
There was this one day where
we kissed.
We come back, the lights were completely off. This would be a great opportunity to fuck him. Not really.
And he was thinking the same thing.
I got on all fours and just like,
oh, what?
Top me.
So I creeping towards him. Popped the lights on, saw that I was just on the floor.
You actually were on the floor?
Yeah, right. Like, creeping towards him, and he didn't see me, and he was quite shocked, and he just burst out laugh him. But as he went, like, did his laugh, like, ah. He was like, oh, wah.
It wasn't sick.
That was him throwing up, yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, so you were naked?
Yeah, yeah. I wasn't naked. We literally just come back in.
Uh-huh. Little balls stroking on the floor.
Yeah, no, it was amusing, very amusing.
I was in the next room with Zoe, and there was one night where we just stayed in because I think we were going out the next night, and I'm too old for it now. But I heard you and Dave get in, and then it was just as I was dozing off, and then I heard Dave's laugh. But it was that loud that I thought he was in the room, and I woke up going, thinking he somehow climbed into the room. Just sat there laughing. It was terrifying.
Yeah. That's never a nightmare, just, that.
Oh, it really is.
It was quite funny.
But I had so much laughter that night. And I was like, so what did you two get up to? You'd watched four weddings in a few
years.
Start to finish.
Yeah, just having
like,
just
like Spanish
bed,
telly.
Just like film four, yeah, it was all we had.
It wasn't even a movie. They just watched four weddings and then
outside the window.
Never seen
one of them
before.
Was there.
He's now in the embrace of God.
top me.
We also watched a film about some killer cow that went around eating people as well after Calvin Harris. That was good.
Fucking weird, aren't they?
It's just something you're doing it.
I hope you don't mind me saying this. When we sort of first arrived, we were in the airport. It was very early on. You said the phrase and be like, no, she's fit. And then you said, you'll probably be hearing me saying that a lot. Oh. But it was
Sigma grind set that.
It was Dave. Dave would do this face when he was on the pull, just walking around, and he sort of goes like that. Do you like the pouting?
Yeah.
I'm like, Dave, you're really good just chatting to people naturally. Like, you can get on with anyone. Why are you pulling that face? Because he'd go round and be like, that's how I'll sort of get a lady.
Yeah, that's all good.
I was like,
yeah.
Dave, that's not your speciality, you know, just use your natural charm. But instead he was looking like he'd sunburnt his face.
He was just shouting, hola, to people.
Yeah.
Sometimes they go, hola, and then he'd just go... I've just never heard Dave.
Pulls out his phrase book.
Have you seen Four Weddings and a Funeral?
We're watching it tonight.
Did you hear that?
You planned that.
I know.
And out the tickets.
Quattro Weddingi El Funeral.
We also got a boat out, which was nice. Very eventful. We went over to the bit where the boats could be, and it was like shallower waters. I think we threw the anchor in, and then you got off for a poo or a wee or throw up.
A bit of both.
So Ryan climbed off onto the rocks to go and be sick. So we pulled the anchor in.
In the sea?
Yeah, I know, but there was a lot of people around.
There was
so
a lot.
I didn't want to just...
So of course, I thought it'd be funny to just drive off. So we drove off, did a little loop, and then came back and got you, threw the anchor in again. Then after about 20 minutes, we wanted to go. During this time, I'd cut my foot on a rock swimming. Me and Dave were very drunk. And then we tried to go and the boat wouldn't move. Oh, we couldn't get the anchor up.
Yeah.
And it had got stuck under a rock.
They do that, yeah.
And it was really far down. And so it was me and Dave trying to get it. And we were probably the most drunk, the least qualified. And I sort of swam down a bit, started yanking it. And as soon as it didn't move, I was like, oh, God, I'm going to drown. So I had to come back up. But it was weird. I went so far and then my head and felt the pressure. Everything popped. And eventually... I got it unhooked, but oh God, we could have been stuck there for ages.
Yeah. It was quite a worried moment. If we weren't drunk, we probably would have worried a bit more.
Yeah.
I like the idea of when you said you went down and started yanking it.
Like, I need to think. Come on, Dave, this is our quiet spot.
How do I do this?
It's one of Ryan's turds.
No. Thank God, that really gets me going.
I would have helped, but I was on drinks duty.
I was drinking fucking 2 litres of seawater.
Drink duty.
Yeah, he was on drink duty.
Sounds like you were just doing your best Little Mermaid impressions, sat on the rocks.
Yeah, I was.
Just doing a
looking
great
cute.
Big old poo.
This is my favourite Disney movie. Under this.
Sebastian covered in scat.
this mild sunburn isn't from Ibiza. It's from yesterday. I was doing a video with Chris MD, Calyx, and Ben Foster, who I met. He's a Premier League goalkeeper. He's very good.
Mm.
Oh, it's just annoyingly good in goal. Chris spoke about the podcast. He actually watches it. He's that guy. so yeah. Thank you, Chris, for watching. Also, look out for those videos when they come out. It's good fun.
But on I did a scale get of one to Ben Foster,
yeah.
Where's Dave? Because he's like the best keeper we know. But
this was a full size goal.
Yeah,
and he's Dave in a full size goal. Do you like Dave in a small goal?
Oh wow!
But Ben Foster's that better.
Wow.
There was one penalty I had, and I smacked it, and he somehow saved it like that bit, knocked it down. Oh, it was just ridiculous. Ruined my day.
Freaky that though, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it.
Weird freaky body.
Yeah, man. Speaking of which, we have a sponsor this week.
Oh,
from Noom.
Speaking of weird freaky bodies.
You can get rid of yours.
Sign up for your trial and get psychology-based support to lose the weight for good at noom.com/Stephen. That's noom.com, N-O-O-M. .com/Stephen. How are you spelling it?
S-T-E-P-H-E-N.
Nice. I think we've already done the minute ad read we have to do. It's a psychology-based approach. Ryan, ever had a psychologist dig around in your brain?
Not yet.
I'd love it if they did and filmed it. Mm. You know, didn't tell you what they found out, but they told everyone else.
Right.
That'd be good. Using a cognitive behavioural approach. Do you know what that is?
No, not really. Cognitive.
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 I remember learning about it in psychology, but I don't know what it is. You'll focus on the why instead of the what to change your relationship with eating. Everybody's journey is different. Some people have billion companies that just you know, dress them, feed them, and work them to the bones, the bloody bones.
That's what I'm looking for, baby. There's bones in here somewhere.
He's gone way too far with this weightless. My God, he's just blood and bones. No food is totally off limits. Hey, Ryan, pretend you're reaching for a custard cream. No. Hang on, with Noom you can do that. Eat them.
Mmm. It always looks so insidious when you're eating a custard cream. Is it like you're up to such dastardly deeds?
That's what Dave's already turned on the lights. More than 80% of users complete the program. More than 60% of users lose 5% or more body weight, and 60% of them keep the weight off for a year or more. Noom has published over 25 peer-reviewed journal articles about the science that goes into their approach to helping people achieve a healthier way of life. Sign up for your trial at noom.com/Stephen. That's noom.com/Stephen. S-T-E-P-H-E-N. God, you are fair. Thank you, Noom.
Cheers, Noom.
First of many.
They can help you lose pounds whilst we gain pounds for the podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah, cheers. Hashtag ad, hashtag read, hashtag ad read. It's time for some complaints. This one's from Jeremy Hamshaw.
Oh, what a strange name.
That's a kinky. Shalom, you sexy boys. Shalom. My complaint is that my tummy makes a big sore when Max makes his big funnies. Please make him stop being such a funny pumpkin and give Ryan a knighthood. Oh, you see, now all that's
wasted. And ruined. This guy's clearly a liar.
You're sincerely your viewer. Just say your viewer as if we know who it is now. Fuck you, Hamshaw.
Maybe they just watch it without any sound and that's why they like it so much. Don't blame him.
Do not blame him, baby. Oh, she's just laughing at Max. Wow, Cameron.
No, really, Cameron. Man.
Yeah, but
we just had a lovely, amusing chuckle. His shoulders just bounce around.
This one subject is, I am fuming. God, no, brace yourself. I genuinely forgot that Ryan is on until the end of the podcast when he ends it with an unenthusiastic goodbye. Max, Stephen and Tom are all pleasant boys. It's a shame that forehead brings the mood down like that. More Cam Green.
Wow.
Well, you sort of got your wish here.
Just wait till my goodbye today. It's going to make you want to kill yourself.
Fuck me.
What? Seriously, let's get that psychologist out.
Is it going to be like a Darren Brown subliminal message? That's going to write kill yourself on your forehead. You're going to see that from space. You're going to be poking the ISS like this. Yeah. It's not worth living. Oh, open the doors, Dimitri.
This one is from Ollie Thompson. Just a quick one. Stephen has mentioned the song Fuck You Right Back a few times and said it was Fergie. Her name was Frankie. It was. God, that's embarrassing. Also, in season one, Max said that Toadfish was from Home and Away. And he's, in fact, from Neighbours. Feels good to get it off my chest. Sorry, guys.
Didn't know Rain Man watched this.
I know you've been holding on to that one, haven't you?
Only Rain Man watched this. Really sorry, guys. Really sorry.
Yeah, sorry about that.
But if anything, mate, fuck you right back, yeah?
Hey, nice.
Fergie. I mean, Frankie.
Really thought you were going for a high five.
High four.
Straight into my face.
You've rubbed up the message. You've just saved that guy's life.
He's sat alone.
Where have I been?
You don't want anyone to kill themselves, do you?
No,
especially
no,
not
I
a listener.
I was only joking.
That's good of you, man.
See you later.
See, that's your level of comedy you do, mate.
Have you'll die. Have you'll die.
That one.
Really tough. Too fat to follow me on Spanish, whatchamacallit, live at the Apollo. I come out and lose my chain, then he comes out. Kill yourselves. I've been round locked.
Only joking.
Oh shit, I forgot the button. No. Come back late. Out. Everybody's dead.
Uncle,
uncle. Oh god. Audience are a bit dead tonight.
This one is from My Transgender Date. I think that's a website we've been signed up to. Thank you. We need a good one to end on. This one says five head. Hey up, not a complaint, but what are you going to do about it? Ryan said he'd take 5k for a gay orgy. Is this the right email to send offers to? £50 for Ryan and an extra 4,000 if he brings the horizontally challenged one with him. All expenses paid. Cheers, D, doing God's work.
Who's the horizontally challenged one?
I'm not oh, let's have a fucking guess, shall we? Fucking horizontally. Oh, the widest one. Fuck
oh,
me.
Oh, vertically, I was... Yeah, right, no, I see.
Unless I met Tom, because he's sort of the other way.
Thanks for your complaints, guys.
Some lovely ones there.
Yeah, great.
It's now time for the news! Johnson's cabinet is falling apart, and I really fully equipped some of our gear. And
yeah,
seat.
That's good.
Satire.
Oh, satire.
Nice.
Cut that. More importantly, in this world of politics and economics and all that shit, Lerpak prices have hit £9.35 in some shops.
What?
Lerpak?
Yeah.
Like, the butter?
Jesus.
Yes. For one tub?
Yeah.
That's mad.
And I've seen some others where they've got, you know, like the yellow circle security protected stickers, they're all on them.
God. On Lerpak?
Yeah.
No wonder the cabinet's packed in. Oh, sick of being empty. You're fucking not going to fill it with Lerpak, are you?
Nice.
What's next, eh?
Yeah, man.
What are we gonna live on?
Well, Lerpak. They've got Danpak and Aldi.
What's Danpak?
Yeah. It's Lerpak.
Yeah, but how much is Danpak?
Oh, I don't know. I imagine it's probably gone up, but
two,
not that much.
2-3 quid last time I saw, but...
Yeah. Speaking of I saw, what do you think, Ryan?
Nice.
It's now time for our first segment.
Oi, did you hear what that loony bloke just said?
This week it's Lockie Bloke, and here is your great bit of gossip. Rita Ora wows in a plunging embellished gown with a thigh-high split and shares a sweet kiss with fiancé Taika Waititi at Thor premiere.
Damn.
No, go on, explain that.
Rita Ora, she's...
Rita Ora, not Rita Ora.
Rita Ora.
Rita Ora.
She's the Mrs. Brown's boys version.
Rita Ora got twatted at a gig. They killed Rita Ora. She did. She's probably worn many lovely dresses. And the guy she was with, who was the guy again?
Taika Waititi.
Taika Waititi.
Tiny bits.
Oi, did you hear what that...
Who's your favourite celebrity couple?
Tiger and Gail.
Invited to the wedding. Fucking efficient. We're gathered here today for Gail. And they're getting married to Gail.
Lovely dress.
Yeah, and you've worn many lovely dresses.
It's now time for our third segment.
Wow.
Cameron, since you were last on, we've had a few wins on this, haven't we?
Heavy. Yeah, too many wins. Yo, they
want to know. Quote from...
The suspension will not be lifted unless I delete the hateful tweet in question, and I would rather die than do that.
Ooh,
man, willing to die over a tweet.
Sure, it's got to be Elon Musk. He has the power.
I might go for the Don. The big Don. The big DT.
Donald Trump?
Yeah.
I was going to go for his son. Can't remember what his name is, though.
Trump Jr., probably.
How is it?
Trumpy Bumpy.
Hey, man.
I'll go Little for Trump. Trump Jr.
Little Trump.
His grandson's called Little Trump.
Big Trump, Little Trump.
Yeah. Cardboard box.
Welcome to our cafe.
Big Trump.
That's what you're calling me, eh?
There's kids watching for the recipe.
yeah, Trump Jr.
Nice.
Oh, great guesses. Wrong. Sorry, it was Jordan Peterson.
He
said Elliot Page's, yeah, I believe, a dead name or, you know, whatever. And he was just a bit of a knobhead. He got kicked off Twitter and he was like, I will never delete that tweet. I'd rather die. That's a weird hill to die on.
He's a strange guy.
Just sort yourself out, mate.
I only ever eat beef and water, and I never cheat. I drink sparkling water. That's my treat. he's so odd.
My favourite.
Does he have wine? Is that it? Is that
no. It as well? I have beef and water, and I never cheat.
John Pease in there. Oh, we can't really clap. that's who the quote was from.
This one goes out to beef.
Yeah,
let's not forget water.
Oh, God, yeah. It's now time for You Laugh, You Lose.
Hey. Oh, fuck me.
Yeah, this is becoming Mac's own segment. eighth time, is it?
Yeah, about that, mate, about that. Eight laughs, though. Eight great laughs.
No, because you've had to do
eight
it.
Eight great laughs. Not just by me, the audience as well, who I'm sure are not getting bored of this segment.
You know who said that this is their favourite part? Chris MD.
Really?
God, like, he's trying to build that bridge, Max.
Hey, Chris, if you like this, then, you know, I'm sure...
We desperately need him on the show.
I'm sure you've got a great sense of comedy, because, you know, there's this, what's on today.
I sent
something over.
Yeah, sure.
Did you know that I've got some great contacts...
Sorry.
Wow.
I just pressed it to get ready. I'm so
Jesus
sorry.
Christ,
I didn't want to interrupt
you. It's ruined everything. hey, guys, did you know I've got really good contacts with the people that deal with bags at the airport?
Why have you got contacts there?
Just, it's good to know people and to network. Last time I went on holiday.
Do you know what, actually? Our bags were really late coming out.
Yeah, they were.
Fuck you, yeah?
Nah, not me, Jesus. Mate. It's one of my many contacts in the area. I'll speak
unreliable,
to
that's what they are.
Yeah. You owe us money.
Oh, you anything, mate?
That was an hour of our time.
Mm. This really is
an hour and 30 seconds. May I?
Does that work? Yeah, I win.
He's outside it.
Yeah, okay. It started.
It's the desperation. Okay, so remember, guys, don't laugh or you'll be doing it next.
What's in the bag there, sir?
Got me Nanzans.
Okay, and where would you be using these?
Oh, probably in a cupboard somewhere, masturbating furiously.
That's awful. I will have to confiscate them.
Bring your own, Max. Bring your own.
You saw through my clever disguise. Thanks for listening to yet another great You Laugh, You Lose. What did you think, Ryan?
Bloody hilarious. So funny.
I was already going, and then I thought, oh no, the last 10 seconds are credits. the baton has been passed back to me. Feel free to join in, guys.
Is that what it's going to be?
We'll take a pity laugh in the future, please. So next week it's me doing it.
Yay!
Yeah.
Finally, a real comedian.
No. It's now time for our second ad read. Oh, yeah. Ooh. That's right. If Noom doesn't work for you, simply shave off all your pubes and you'll be much lighter. That's right. It's Manscaped.
Yay!
Our old friends.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Got bush? You definitely do if you haven't tried the best products from our sponsor today. Or you might be prepubescent. Talk to him, Cam.
About being prepubescent. That was once me. Till age 4.
Really?
Yep.
Oh,
my
God.
Balls grew at a much faster rate than the rest of me.
That and a tin opener for a foot.
Yeah. I was a sick boy. Little machine boy. Great big hairy pubes and a melting out of foot. My left hand was a whisk.
I'm sure it'd be great if your left hand was maybe like a Manscaped razor.
Oh, that'd incredible.
Yeah, man. These products are so good, you're going to be showing pride in your bush, in your new bush-free yard. It's a fact that you will have the best-kept nutsack on the cul-de-sac. Save big and be the most hygienic version of yourself by using our discount code STP20 for 20% off and free shipping at manscaped.com. It's basic landscaping. When you trim the hedges, the trees stand taller.
Nice.
Great information.
It's true.
Thank you. The second best tool in the performance package is the Weed Whacker. This fine-tuned nose and ear hair trimmer, my girlfriend, simple mistake to make, seen both in the bath, together.
Oh, God. They come in bloody handy, these weed whackers, don't they?
It's just one person in his house. Hey. Your sister and your girlfriend.
Oh, you imply they're the same person, yeah? Joke's on you. Neither of them exist. They're a clever ruse by me. I've got lots of wigs.
Yeah, I've just got to get my sister quick.
And a big imagination. Watch this. Hello!
Hello! Have you seen your sister?
No, Dad. Here I am!
Why didn't you scare off the muggers with that? Shut up. Look out. Tyson of Fury's here.
Hey, you big dosser.
It's a me, Rey Mysterio.
Where were we? With a performance package purchase, you get two free gifts.
Nice.
The shed travel bag and the patented high performance reduced chafing mount. I need reduced chafing boxes. Mm. Please send them out to us. Yesterday got chafed up to something fierce, yeah?
Mm.
Owie!
Just running or walking about.
Just running, mate, because of the football challenge. Awful.
She.
Get 20% off and free shipping with our code STP20 at manscaped.com. Talking points. I'll go first because I have a great talking point, guys.
Nice.
It's not that great. Do you think you survive, and not literally, a year like at an American college, to like a university?
Yeah. Oh, God. Like a...
I don't mean survive. I just mean, you know, like at the frats.
Yeah.
Their way of life.
That. Yeah.
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 You're sick.
Well, the thing is that in their colleges, their rooms you share with someone else.
Mm.
So it'd be like maybe a bit bigger than this room.
Easy.
And there's two people in there. Don't you think that's so weird?
Just making me a bitch, don't you?
Really?
Walk in, first day, don't fuck about. What's your name? Derek Rogerson. Yeah, well in, Derek.
Hey, I'm the one who rogers sons around.
Here's my friends, Bert and Ernie. Welcome to Sesame Street. Skadoosh. Straight out, who comes in next? The Dean. Hello, Dean. Meet Gonzo. Dwaff. Own the gaff, don't you? Who comes in next? All of them. Straight out the window.
So you're pretending your fist is Sesame Street character. Sesame Street.
tiny
little real version. Seed.
The size of a grain of rice. You'll never see him coming. They're quicker than a human eye.
So you've got tiny sesame seed arms.
And a testicle. That's all I am. Bouncing around on my testicles. You never see him coming.
You're going to beat up everyone that comes into your room.
Easy, yeah.
How are you going to get into a frat? Or do you not want a frat?
Frat comes to me, doesn't it?
Yeah.
They come to me for protection.
Oh, really? So you're sort of like a mafia...
It's not like a cartel. It's not like a mafia family where I railroad people and say, I'm going to destroy your car if you don't come and pay me tribute. Just drop me bollocks on them. Me Fiesta! Dush.
That's sexual harassment. You know?
Could be.
Yeah.
Could be.
Or who's going to stop me?
I mean, the police at this rate.
Are they?
Got guns.
Are they? Yeah, they're going to shoot your testicles.
I've got giant...
How big are these testes?
Your old balls are no cock, you.
Well, you would be, wouldn't you? If you had testicles the size of...
Your little sesame seed just poking out.
Yeah. The balls get bigger and I get smaller. So eventually I'm just a sesame seed.
What course would you do? Could you do the same course?
Wouldn't you do a course, would you? You just go for a party, go for a good time.
Mm. Really?
That's what Zuckerberg did, didn't it?
I think he was working on a website as well.
Yeah, but he didn't do his course, did he? He just turned up, banged out a website, no problem. check out my balls.com.
Please, doctor.
You'll need going.
I'm so worried.
They can't be stopped. Please. Where are you, doctor? Trying to pull them out. Please.
You can't stop us.
What about you, Max?
I think the roommate thing is a bit weird. I probably wouldn't be able to deal with.
You had a thing where no one could go in your room.
Yeah, no, I didn't like anyone in my room.
In the crevice. Yeah. It was
it's in my private space and no one was allowed in.
So you have to share a room.
I have to share a room. That's tough.
Yeah. When you get used to it, like after a week, you're just like...
Oh, I think I'll get used to it. Definitely get used to it. And I think I'd enjoy it.
Whereabouts in America, if you just be... Oh, if you were just plunked at the comedy course in Illinois.
Gotta be LA, mate. Gotta be the sunny coast.
You hate the warmth.
Too hot.
I'd wear a tank top everywhere.
You hate sharing your room. You hate the warmth.
Be so close to it all. You know, I'd be in the Warner Brothers studios, go in, check me out.
That's
give me
expensive,
a job.
Though.
I'll have the money.
What is going on here?
At what point do the Warner Brothers Studios staff just let you in? What reason do you give them as security? You walk up, hello, yeah, you all right?
Can I
just show myself off? I would have you.
There's a northern... Well, you're not northern. I've got so used to the fucking Yorkshire.
Hey, Magum.
There's a bloke here in a vest. Yeah, demands to see.
He's sweating my back out.
Aren't you the same fella from yesterday? No, he wasn't from Yorkshire. Silly me. Come on.
What about the frat?
I'd love to join a frat.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, so do frats have, like, themes?
I think, I don't know if they've got themes, but they've got, like, this rules. Is the one that the jocks go to. The nerds go to that one.
Right. I don't think nerds have frats.
Of course they do.
Maybe not frats, but
we're probably too respectful and, like, not wet enough to enjoy being in a frat. Because don't they all go,
you're saying they're wet, and yet...
They'll be wet when I arrive.
With ball sweat.
I turn a super bring my super soaker and chain up to my bollocks. Are you going to let me in? Are you going to meet my little friend? So, two really, really big friends.
So let's say they don't let you in. You spray them with hot potent semen. Are you then just going to go inside now with them all soaked in semen and you're just like, hey, I'm new friend guy.
I warned you. I warned all of you. Keep the fucking noise down.
Or else!
So you've joined a frat to keep the volume down. Yeah. I'm confused about your time. Most of the Max is now.
Not as confused as me.
I'm confused, boys.
Call me into the dean's office. Do you know what you've been doing? No. No, not on it.
Ryan, what are you going
to
do?
I'll go because I have to. I think.
Don't have to.
Yeah, I know, but.
Hey, man, do you want a drink?
I wouldn't have not gone. I think the roommate is a big. Yeah. Quite a big thing, at least with uni here. Like
you shared with Dave. Room.
Yeah, no, I'd enjoy it. Yeah.
It'd be tough for that. It'd be tough for your roommate. You on the fours all the time. God, imagine if you had a power cut. You're rubbing your hands together.
I'd enjoy the lifestyle, the frat parties.
Oh, God, talk to him.
Yeah. Talk to him. Yeah, I'll talk to him.
What else? That sort of thing.
Yeah. I'll be there with my red cups.
Yeah. Oh, doing like the three ball trick.
Yeah. I'm making all the drinks for everyone.
Oh, you're such a bitch.
How about yourself, Stephen?
Oh, I like the idea of it when I was younger. Now the whole sharing a room.
Yeah, I think that's the weird part.
Because if you don't get any say or they match it up randomly, then you're probably getting a bit of a weirdo. But it could be good.
They're all too high energy and exhausting as people.
Yeah. I'd like to go to New York. Very expensive, though.
Yeah, I can imagine.
If you're a student, God. Yeah. If it's like London, you get more money.
You'd have to. Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
My breakfast bagel, $8. Who are you trying to mug here, you fool?
Cheaper than Lurpak.
Yeah, that's true enough. Yeah,
that is true.
I get a whole tub of Lurpak in my bagel. 1-0 to me. Good little character I'm working on.
Yeah, I like that.
His name's Daniel Lurpak.
They call me Daniel Lurpak.
They do if they want to... Smack on the tush. It's laypack, you fool. Spread him. Shut up, mate.
Sorry. Can't let you said spread him, though. Is it?
You're definitely not in the Chicago comedy scene.
Oh, yeah.
They know when to come in. God.
I will be.
It's now time for this great segment.
Stephen lies. Stephen, sweet little lies. Oh yeah, he's proper fit and gives me a wide on.
He make me pum pum wide. Max, you are the detective this week.
Stephen, what's your little story?
I fouled the sea.
You fouled the sea.
I fouled the sea.
Oh God!
Really let it down.
All right, okay, Ryan.
I guess I was robbed whilst on holiday.
If you look at Ryan and get his forehead in that bit, it's really...
Oh, God.
Yeah,
so this is Ryan's crying. Another segment.
Like Megamind.
Megamind.
I've had that before.
Cameron, what is your story?
I won a little contest in Barcelona for having the best tushy in a club.
Okay, okay.
So it's down to two.
You cheeky fuck.
Is that what the trophy said?
We all know it's the best little tushy in the whole of Spain, honey.
How did no one's trying to pinch that. Stinks of shit.
Nice.
Stinks of shit. Barcelona.
If there's ever anything to really upset me, it's that. I'm very self-conscious about me, little bumble.
How did they judge it?
It was while we were in this club. They were trying to liven it up. They might do it every night, I don't know, and didn't go back. And everyone was going on stage, and you basically just whipped your kets a little bit down, got your undies and pulled them up and showed your little bum cheeks.
You showed your little bum cheeks.
Your dirty pontins, this.
Yeah, we thought lots of people had come to it, but not many, very many people did.
Yeah.
And I won, also like the 5 or 6 other people that did it.
I assume all these other people were men.
No, no.
Really?
Two ladies.
Okay.
So. I don't believe that you would win a best arse competition and complain about the city. I think that would overshadow everything.
Well, maybe like, that's why I got
best place
tapped on the way home. People are following me, trying to get a piece of me. And when they can't get the prime rib, they'll just take whatever they can get.
They'll take the chain.
Take the rump.
So who judged? Was there like judges or is it the crowd reaction?
Yeah, sort of crowd reaction. I did play it up. And then the judge was just the guy who was on stage, a little bit of an MC.
And he went, oh, that's
DJing
all right.
After.
Yeah. Okay, fair. Do you feel like you deserved the win?
Well, at risk of talking publicly about other people's bodies, you know, I'm not one to toot my own horn, but
nice.
It's worth a tooting about.
Okay.
Happy little cheeks.
From
they look
one...
bouncy.
Okay, so okay, fair. Okay, fine. Stephen, you fouled the sea.
Better bums around this table.
What are you trying to do?
Are we talking wee or are we talking poo?
Hear out the goodness of my heart, yeah?
Max, if there's one thing you should know about me, past life, that was actually this one, I shat in the sea.
Okay.
It's something that I sort of held with a somewhat dignity. Until this holiday when it happened for the second time.
He's just jealous because he can't get his bum to behave.
Hey!
It's a wild tush.
A naughty little tush.
It's like a Pokemon game. Stephen's arse appeared.
He's playing games with my bum, yeah?
Yeah.
You've never said that before. Showing off now.
I did, I woke up, he was playing swing ball with it.
With the bum.
I was winning 3-0.
It's because every time I was going to hit it, he did a little poop.
No, that's a lie. That is not part of my story. This was on the second day of the holiday.
Okay.
And we got the boat.
Yep.
I was struggling to drink for some reason. The first night we went to this lovely restaurant, went to it the first time.
Yeah.
I got these passion fruit? No, porn star martini with the passion fruit in. Disgusting. Couldn't touch it.
Really?
I ordered one, had a sip, I went, I can't do this. And
okay.
I thought, and last year, loved them.
Yeah.
So that morning of the boat, well, we went out on the boat about 3 p.m. I went to the bar because Dave had been getting these lovely drinks. Mm-hmm. So I thought, I'll get a pina colada.
Beautiful drink.
Easy to drink. And then we went out onto the boat, drinking more. Mm-hmm. I was driving first, so Ryan was on the drinks. I was ploughing these down. So I'm a little bit wavy.
Yeah.
Nice, fun.
And we get to the bit where we dock off.
Yep.
So he's got a rubber ring.
Bark.
That's the one. Ryan's got the head of a Lilo. We couldn't blow the rest of it up.
Okay.
Long story. It's real tough. It was out that we just had the big head for you. They were in there, sort of together, a little bit too close. Whilst Dave and myself, I think Dave stayed on the boat at this point. Yeah. At this point, I got off. I initially went for a wee.
Nice.
That was fine. But then I did what was a fart. A classic little fart.
Okay.
And I thought nothing more of it. But then the smell... It was obviously hideous, but that's what happens. I fart in the shower and you get that smell. Yeah,
10 times as worse.
So when I look down, I see You see, do you like the... When I say this, it's not what you're thinking. It's like a brown crayon in water. Not in terms of the solidity.
But yeah.
In terms of like the brown floaty water moving off.
Yeah.
So I found in the sea. Right. But what I put it down to was in the pina colada, there was probably some sort of lactose in it. So that's found in the sea now.
Anyone, do you tell anyone, or was this something you kept to yourself?
Not at the time, because I did it right by the ladder.
Right, okay.
Oh, no.
Well, the boat moved around a little. It was anchored, but it could move.
Oh, nice of him.
Yeah.
Oh, you did worse.
Yeah. In the sea?
Definitely.
100%.
Just putting your little body in there. Pollute it.
Okay, so no one's heard the story. You just did it. And then did you have to wipe, or?
No.
Do you think the water just sort of washed it away?
I've never sharted. Well, not in the past. Not in my adult life.
Yeah.
I think that's what it was.
A classic shot in the
sea. Combination of dairy.
Okay.
Maybe a little bit of tipsiness.
Okay, a lot of tushy talk. What about yourself, Ryan?
A lot of tushy talk.
So I was drinking with Dave. It was just me and Dave.
Yeah.
We were on our way back to the hotel.
Well, no girls.
Lie. Never was. So we were walking back. We saw this guy selling balloons. And we were like, fuck it, let's get some balloons.
Yeah.
So the deal was, made a deal with him, 4 balloons for 15 euros. And he gave us our first balloon each.
Mm-hmm.
We did the balloon. But as we were doing
Ooh, you're hard.
Yeah. When we finished our balloon, we realised that he had gone.
And they weren't.
He was nowhere to be seen. We walked all the way down the strip to try and find this man because he owed us 2 balloons. We simply couldn't find him.
Right.
Two for 15 isn't the end of the world.
No, it's not.
You've paid more.
The principal was there.
The principal was there. Did you speak to him? You're not in this frat anymore, boy.
We were expecting 4, you know?
Yeah, of course you were. Did they get you lightly buzzed?
Yeah, I mean, for like 5 seconds, yeah.
Yeah, waste of money.
When a real head buzz, just swim down.
Yeah.
But about 5 metres, that'll do it.
Yeah.
But we probably spent about 20 minutes looking for this man.
20 minutes?
Get a life, mate.
Yeah, I know. Probably should have got a life. But, you know,
it's the principal,
20 minutes of your evening walking around.
Yeah, looking.
So you lost €7.50, basically.
Pretty much, yeah.
Not much of a story.
That's just true, though, isn't it?
But it's the sort of thing Ryan would say.
Yeah. Principal of Ibiza gave him both a detention. For the rest of the night, they're stuck in writing, doing the wrong kind of lines.
They just passed 4 weddings and a funeral on DVD. Watch this.
Don't enjoy it. You're meant to be a punishment.
It was a good film, actually, 4 weddings and a funeral, but...
No, more on that later. Okay. Cameron, I wish yours was true. Yeah, I just don't believe it.
That's a shame.
Mate, it could be true.
I wouldn't shit in the sea.
But it doesn't sound like it was something that you did on purpose, if you did do it.
When I was younger, I did it on purpose.
Yeah.
I'd do it again.
Hey. I can't do it. I physically can't do it.
What? Shit in the sea?
I can stand in the sea for about an hour, pulling faces like...
So you've tried.
Yep.
I'd say that's worse than actually shitting in the sea.
Gun to your head.
Trying
mate.
For an hour.
Wish you could. Gun to your head, mate.
Well, gun to my head, I'd probably shit anywhere.
Yeah, of course.
probably me keks, first of all. I'm going to fucking gun to my head, yeah.
Enjoy America, man.
Who's trotting me out to the scene? Do it.
Fucking
do it now.
Lay some pipe, baby. Ryan, I think you did what you said you did.
This is true. Well done.
Yep.
I swear you had a better story than that, didn't you? You pooed 5 times in one morning, Ryan.
Yeah. That's the one you said to go for.
I said go for the poo one. I thought that was better.
Oh. My shits were so quick, though.
Fucking rapid fire.
save that chat for the ladies. I've got quick stools. It's now time for a new segment to Cameron. It's been sweeping the nation.
Ooh.
It's Maxie's Taxis.
That's right, it's Maxie's Taxis. In this game, Max will call up a taxi rank. We write down a word each on here, and if he says it, or if the person on the phone says it, he has to have one of these very sour sweets and continue with the conversation. Oh God, they've been out in a warm day.
So do we want him to say these words?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Okay. Right, have you got a word?
Yeah.
Okay. Just Don't let Max see it, but if you write it down.
You bastard!
Oh, the electric shock!
Oh, you bastard!
Oh, really?
I'd have fall for that.
Right, let's think of a word, Ryan.
I've already got one, mate.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, naughty, that, mate.
Don't let him see it.
I'm not looking, don't worry.
Why is he ever going to say that?
If he says the word, he gets to eat sour sweet.
Oh, so we want
him. He doesn't get to. He has to.
He has to say.
Chizzy Winkle. Chizzy Winkle.
Be a place.
Hello, Chizzy Winkle, Texas.
Can you drop me off near Chizzy Winkle? Oh, so I can't have pimple peen either.
Just go for a common word.
A common word, okay.
So basically, if he says a word, or they say a word, we'll tell you to give Max a sweet.
You've got to pop a sweet in my mouth.
Did you just suck them off my fingers? And...
They're very sour sweets, by the way.
Yeah, no, I've had one before.
Okay.
Hey, right, we ready?
Yeah, this is Maxi's Taxis, Nottingham edition.
Hello, I just need a taxi, if that's okay.
Yeah, please tell me your pickup address, sir.
Yeah, of course. I'm on Green's Windmill. I'm at the top floor. Obviously, I'll come down. I don't know where the nearest road is.
Green's Windmill.
Have you heard of it? It's next to Pink Windmill. No, it's not. It's just green. I need to get to Pumping Station.
That's fine. It's a green windmill. Green, a clean... Which area is it? The Green Windmill.
It's in the windmill area of Nottingham. I need to get to Pumping Station.
It's a windmill lane, correct?
Do you know what? Let's just go with that. It's a lane with windmill.
Okay, yeah, I'm just sending the car on windmill lane in Nottingham.
Do I have to wear a hat?
Sorry?
Do I need to wear, like, something so he knows that it's me? How will he know it's me? Do I...
Do you know about there's a snack
tent
of the carriage in Windmill Lane?
Do I know that? All I know is the windmill. I'm on the top floor of the windmill. You know the windmill is not even green; it's red. It's made of brick.
Yeah, you're right. And it's a green windmill with a 5 seconds. Here you are.
Can I ask you a favour?
Yeah, please.
I've got my glasses on, but I don't know, would the taxi driver be able to look at my glasses and know it's me? They're made of...
He will find you easily because when he arrives, he'll ring you the same number.
Is the taxi driver a man or a woman?
It should be a man, sir.
Oh.
Okay, and I need to know one thing more. I'm thinking they asked me one thing. You are in the green windmill, which is in the windmill lane in Nottingham. Am I correct?
No, I'm at Pumping Station.
I'm asking for a pickup address, sir.
I've got my glasses on in the Pumping Station and I feel a bit sick.
So that's fine, but...
No, it's not fine, because I've been trumping all day.
Do you hear me, sir?
No. Who?
Do you hear me now?
Hear me now, yes.
I'm asking that. I'm just going to send the car to Green's Windmill and Science Centre, which is in Windmill Lane.
All I know is I'm on top floor. I could be anywhere, I don't know.
You just give us a call.
There's a lady here, can I ask her, and then I'd speak to her?
Yeah, please.
Okay, excuse me, love, do you know where I am? You're on top floor. Okay, thank you, bye. She says I'm on top floor.
Just call us back, please.
Okay. Love you, bye.
Give us a call, thank you, bye.
My God. He was never hanging up.
Okay, then.
I'm so hungry. You done it?
No. What were the three words?
Go right and petrol. Not Chizzy Winkle penis pumpy. Oh, the pumpy was close.
Yeah.
Oh. Good that.
That's horrendous.
I'm just gonna check on Max because he seems to be in a bad way. You two are talking about yourselves.
Okay,
you
mate.
You don't have to.
that was coming.
No, I don't think anyone. I don't think he did. Funny, especially.
That was really funny.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Whoa, is it Wayne the Nicker?
Just might be.
No, I don't know.
Oh, sorry, lad.
Hi, mate.
Oh, Wayne the Nicker.
Oh, Wayne.
Nice to meet you, Wayne.
Oh, you've met me before.
Oh, yeah.
Came onto my premises asking for the balloon, man.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
Beaded.
Was he on all fours at the time?
No. He was after we dealt with him. Security chopped to the neck.
Yeah,
like that.
Yeah, it was a crazy night, wasn't it, Wayne?
Well, it was for us.
Yeah.
You looked like you were properly on it.
Yeah.
Eyes going everywhere.
Proper gozzy eye, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got on quite well, didn't we?
You said it was nice to meet me about a minute ago.
Yeah. Just so,
what were
so
you on
drunk
that day,
Ryan? What wasn't on?
Cloud nine.
What brings you here today, Wayne?
Miss me flight.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Well, what were you here for in the first place? Didn't you live in Ibiza?
Yeah, I was going from Manchester to Ibiza.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess I can promote me great businesses.
Yeah, go on if you want. You are here after all, I suppose.
Go to my businesses. Ocean Beach.
Do you own Ocean? Do you own Ocean Beach?
Yes, I fucking do, and I think your friend Stephen told you that several times, you dozy twat.
Not so sure.
Open your ears for once.
Have you thought about lowering the prices in Ocean Beach?
Have you thought about coming to Ocean Beach in the first place? God, you're so tight, I'd probably shag you.
Thanks, Wayne.
I wouldn't, though. Maybe let you apply the after sun to my back. That's about it, in terms of sexual.
Do you still speak to your brother a lot?
Myself and Gary have gone separate ways.
Oh, right.
I've gone down the successful businessman route.
Yeah.
He's gone down the preaching on Twitter route. Loony lefty.
Yeah.
Wish he was left in the sea. Fucking Walker's crisps.
Would you say you're the more good-looking brother?
Would you say it?
Yeah.
There you go.
I would.
Say no more.
I think there's something going on here.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I think there's definitely something going on here.
I can sense a real tension between you two.
Something happened in Ibiza that we don't know about.
Why don't you just tell us what happened?
Sounds like you're fishing for some content.
Maybe I am.
I took a pill in Ibiza.
Yep.
It was a blue one. I saw this boy.
Yeah.
On the floor, on all fours, in fact.
In the dark.
That sounds about right.
I mistook his anus for a sandcastle.
Oh, God.
I was gripping it to see how sturdy it was. Turns out not very.
Oh,
crumbled in your hands.
Exactly, it did. But that was just the outer coating of the shit smeared against his swim shorts, dried in the sun. Once we washed him away in the sea, I said...
She was nice enough to do.
Absolutely, I'm a father first, Min Shagger second.
Yeah.
I was washing his bottom, and he sort of came to. Not like that, come on, keep it clean. And I said to him, hello, boy, why aren't you in Ocean Beach? What did you say?
I said to you, I can't really afford your cocktails, mate.
Exactly, and I said, why not?
Because I've lost my wallet.
Oh, how's that happened?
I was swimming in the sea and
a
fish nicked it.
That sounds like bullshit to me.
It does, to be fair. That was so bad.
It just fell out in the sea.
Why'd you have your wallet in the sea?
I just forgot I had it on.
How much did that swim cost you?
God, about 100 euros. Fuck. And I was
100 euros
that
in your wallet? That's pathetic.
I was going to use that to get myself a cocktail from Ocean Beach.
They're not 100 euros.
No,
one cocktail.
You've got to get admission first.
Yeah, that's true.
40 euros.
Yeah.
Especially for you.
Yeah.
Cheaper for ladies. Do you got a sister?
No, I don't.
Daughter?
No.
Forget it.
So you won't.
You don't know me.
Wow.
I'm just a bloke who's cleaned your arsehole out.
I was going to say. Yeah.
Turn my attention to this guy. Do you want to come to Ocean Beach?
Mate, I'd love to. From what I hear, it's amazing.
Absolutely. The best place in Ibiza.
Get your bum washed.
No, that was just for him.
Yeah. Oh. I need a wash.
Have you got IBS?
I could do for you, Wayne.
Tell you what, a little champagne spray in your crack.
Yes.
A little bit of Moët right down there.
Little bit of the bubbly right next to the hole.
Yeah. No. Yeah.
Nice.
What about you?
No, thanks.
No one says no to Wayne. No males, at least.
I don't think I've exactly said those words, I'm afraid.
Why are you afraid?
You frighten me.
Oh, don't be frightened.
I've got a dirty bum.
Tell me more.
So what are you actually doing here, though? Like, I know you're waiting for your flight. Or you missed your flight.
3 hour delay. I thought I'd have a walk around Manchester.
Yeah. Do you watch the podcast? Listen to it.
Podcast.
Yeah, this is a podcast.
I thought it was live TV.
Oh no.
A podcast.
Yeah, yeah. This will come out
like
next
a top
week.
50 on Spotify sort of podcast.
Yeah, one day.
Oh, I wouldn't say.
What do you mean one day?
Hey, we're climbing, baby.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Or we're falling.
It will be.
Oh, fuck this! I'm getting no noise, no news even. You've filled me with hope.
Yeah.
And I filled you with lovely radox and seawater. Yeah. You're a slut.
Maybe I am, Wayne.
Any holes a goal?
That's what you said a lot in Ibiza.
It's all on a T-shirt.
As he was washing your ass.
Well, that was no goal.
Yeah.
It was wide open. Couldn't miss.
Yeah, yeah.
You'd have any goalkeeper in there. Yeah. I'd still score.
Brilliant.
Nice to see you, Wayne.
Do you want to say anything, Wayne, to our podcast listeners before you go?
Come to Ocean Beach. You'll have a great time. Loads of celebs go there. Dean Gaffney. Who else? What's your name?
Ryan.
Ryan over here saw Dean Gaffney. Be sure to come to Ocean Beach, where no Gary Linekers will be, because he's off selling crisps, the little fruitcake. See you later.
See you later, Wayne.
Bye, Wayne.
Bye.
He did ruin my holiday a little bit, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
At least you got a clean bum for a bit.
True, yeah, true. You saved me a job when I got home.
Yeah, yeah.
You didn't dirty your bum once.
Oh, sorry, I was gone for a minute there.
That's all right.
It's all right, mate.
Ryan can have six poos in an hour without dirtying his bum, apparently.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
He's got friends in high places ready to clean him out.
High places, because...
Hey! Speaking of that, it's time for Obscene Green.
Oh. Obscene Green.
Obscene. Oh, green. I think we have a jingle. Don't worry.
Cammy Whammy G tells you how it's gonna be.
You can't handle the truth!
Well, I didn't vote for you!
You're right, if you're still here after that, more fool you. Thank you. Ow! So, right, the only one this week, and we need to decide it ourselves. The cabinet's fallen apart. The country is in a shambles.
Have you kept the IKEA receipt?
Hey! Played the joke thief thing, we did that one already.
I did it.
You steal your own joke, that still counts, doesn't it?
No.
See, this is the problem. There's no accountability.
Mm. There is.
People can't keep an eye on their elected officials, and that's why
can't steal your own
they need
joke.
To be filmed.
Just make callbacks.
24/7. We're going to turn Parliament into Love Island.
Not Love Island, it's probably already that sort of...
But we pick a show.
Big Brother. That's what I'd like.
Yeah.
Because they sort of get tortured a bit.
There's no manufactured drama, though.
It happens naturally. Have you ever seen Big Brother?
No.
Pound for pound, minute for minute, Big Brother has more controversy, more... scandal.
It's a bit Orwellian. It's a bit 1984, like Big Brother constantly watching people. But
isn't that the life we live now?
They work for us.
Oh, God, yeah, so true.
CCTV everywhere.
Everywhere.
I do kind of
bathroom.
Think...
Your Big Brother watching you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't have one.
Yes.
That must be your dad.
Yeah. No.
Your uncle dad.
I don't have an uncle dad.
Who watches you on the toilet, then, if it's not your uncle dad?
I do.
Your neighbour. Oh,
that makes a lot of sense. So, we turn Parliament into somewhere where we can watch them all the time, and then if they don't do the job...
It's Keshi's Castle.
That would be good.
Whoever makes it to the end becomes Prime Minister.
Because that shows, you know, they've got grit and drive and determination.
Yeah, and you've got Craig Charles.
And balance.
Bingo. And balance, yeah. That's what
Craig
we need.
Charles,
a well-balanced leader.
Do they have to speak Japanese?
No, I don't reckon so.
Be good.
Mm. I don't reckon that's essential.
Yeah, a better way of voting... Prime Minister, though.
Saves us a lot of aggro at election time, doesn't it?
I've also never seen anyone win Takeshi's Castle.
Oh, I have.
Have you?
You watch Challenge TV enough, you'll see.
Less people have won Takeshi's Castle than have got to the moon.
I think it's 7 people have won Takeshi's Castle.
There might be 8 people who have gone
to
the moon, then.
Probably more, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So what are we going for, then?
Takeshi's Castle. Parliament's Takeshi's Castle.
How about Come Down With Me? You could have a series of shows to narrow it down.
Oh, God.
Come Down With Me could be like a Final Four.
The Slammer.
And then you could get down to
that would be good if they were in the Slammer, yeah?
Yeah, but there was no show.
Oh!
Satire.
Yeah. So I like this idea. I think this might be one of the better ones.
This was your idea.
Yeah, I know. I'm just tooting me on horn. So I reckon we go for this one. We're all happy. First round, Takeshi's Castle.
We haven't established Takeshi's Castle. But then which
There's
round
lots of people
from Takeshi's
in that.
Castle?
The whole thing.
No, because then you're left with one.
That's fine. Bring new people in.
Squid Games. Could do it like that.
Yeah, just kill it's them. Not Squid Games. Squid Game.
Oh, you just got fucking owned, right?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Split that up. Yes.
Cameron, you make the rules around here.
I can't really be fussed thinking about anymore, so... Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it.
Pop goes the weasel.
He's like Thor.
Hope you're all happy. Never happen. Your country is going to let you down for the rest of your life. And most people will die, not living to the fullest. And it's not your fault most of the time. God. It's the terrible country's fault. Comedy podcast, everyone. Comedy podcast.
Just you wait to my goodbye.
Oh, God. Yeah,
it's now time for Ryan's trying.
Hello there. My name is Ryan Locke.
Send him off! Send the dressing gates off! Get him off the field!
I'll keep it brief there.
Thank you. So in this segment, I'm going through my old jokes.
Yeah, you are.
Back from when?
Is that one of them?
Some of them, I think, are from uni. So,
what's the deal with all these girls? It's rude. Please welcome to the stage, Ryan Long. Yeah.
Hello.
Had a bad week. I need this.
To sum myself up to you, I don't want to brag, but I've recently graduated from the University of Salford.
Yeah.
In a writing and performing comedy degree.
You feel like killing yourself.
I got a 2-1. And as you can imagine, I've landed myself a pretty steady job in the catering and hospitality industry.
You get your 1-2 later.
It's okay, though, because I'm single. Single and ready to mingle.
Ooh.
Or in my case, single and ready to cry into a tube of Pringles.
That's so bad.
In my degree, if I added another Pringle joke, I probably would have got a first. But I only got a 2-1.
What is the joke there?
I don't know.
Is that a joke?
I
was like, where's the pun going to come from?
None like, of
once you pop, you just can't stop. Oh, right.
The joke never ends.
the joke never ends.
That sounds like a really good tour show.
The real joke is my life.
It will end one day.
Never ends.
He pulls out his pistol.
Wait for my goodbye.
You should have laughed. At least once.
Goodbye.
But you know, I don't want to leave you thinking that I'm one of these comedians that comes on stage.
Don't worry about that. We are not worried about that, baby.
I don't want you to think I'm one of those comedians who comes on stage and moans and talks about, you know, how sad they are, because I'm actually quite happy despite my loneliness and collection of diarrhea tablets.
Yeah.
One more.
Just one.
This one time, right? And this is a true story.
One time.
I was in bed with a girl. That's not really the end. I was in bed with a girl who I really fancied.
Nice.
And she turned round to me and said,
she was facing the other way.
You're like a gay best friend to me. And I said, fuck off, Catherine, I'm not gay.
That sounds more for therapy than for comedy.
Ryan's trying.
It was even a joke. Fuck off, Carol. Fuck off, Carol. I'm not gay. That's my joke.
While he was in her as well.
Do you think I'm supposed to use that as stand-up now? Would it work?
It's got to be ironically.
Yeah.
Like, you know it's shit.
Yeah. And the audience have to know that that's shit.
What worries me is that, you know, I was obviously writing that at uni.
Thinking it was good.
Yeah, yeah.
Aww.
That's why you got a 2-1.
True.
Don't we just think of one of those comedians?
It's now time for Put It To The Max.
Put it to the max, to the max, put it to the max.
Help! You would think I was mad preggers with how hard my husband just screwed me. Fucking klutz, I tell him. Go do the lotto. Mama wants a new hot tub, and his measly job ain't going to provide one for me. I say I want bubbles on me toes. He laughs and throws lemonade at me webs. Ree! Me Louis Vuittons are ruined. And me numbers came in. £100 million gone down the drain. What do I do? I want to kill him. Help me, boys.
I guess.
Poor woman.
So she's just had a Louis Vuitton's ruined.
Yeah,
it's obviously expensive.
So expensive,
and she missed out on $100 million on the lottery.
Yeah, yeah.
Furious, wouldn't you?
And numbers came in.
First thing you do would be to email a podcast.
Well, I think, you know, is she's got to look at herself a little bit here. You can do it all online these days from an app on your phone.
That's true.
And, you know, whilst you got your husband spilling lemonade on your sweet toes, could have been downloading the app, putting your numbers in.
Yeah, that's true, man.
Sweet lemonade on your toes as well.
$100 million, though.
You'd be furious.
You want a jacuzzi, was it?
Yeah, hot tub.
She'd probably get that just saving up for a year or two.
Mm. Yeah.
Watching what she spends her money on.
Don't give up on your dreams.
Absolutely.
There are other ways to make money. It is annoying that you missed out on that money.
But she should have done it herself, maybe. And the ironic thing is the next week, those numbers are still just as likely to come up.
Yeah.
But you'll never probably do it again.
Yeah, so true.
God, that's very true, isn't it?
Yeah, man.
Think like that.
Great problem that the ladies come with. Should we act it out?
Yeah.
We need a wife and husband, and then maybe a shop owner.
I'll be a lemonade vendor.
Okay.
I'll be the shop owner as long as I don't end up as some kind of paedophile.
I wonder what twist this one's going to take.
I'll be the shop owner then.
Okay.
Probably for the best.
Yeah, I'll be the husband.
Okay, I guess I'm the woman.
Yeah.
Oh, do you want me to be the woman?
Either way.
So, lemonade. Get your lemonade.
Hey, don't sell that outside my shop.
Sorry. Would you like some lemonade?
The audacity. Go on, have a bottle.
How about you, madame, with those dry toes?
I think I'm the madam over here. looking at me husband. Looking at me paedophile husband. I'm the one that wants lemonade.
Your husband looks very effeminate. I'll happily provide you with some lemonade.
Come in my shop and buy it.
Whoa.
Very cheap, very nice.
I think we should go into the shop.
Don't talk to me about money. You don't know nothing about no money.
I'm sorry about that.
Could have got me 100 million.
I'll treat you to a lemonade.
Mine's cheaper.
Treat you to a fucking lemonade.
Cheap lemonade over here.
Mine's cheaper.
Nope.
How much is yours?
1 penny less than his.
How much is yours?
Free.
Fuck me. So I get a penny.
Yeah.
Fuck me. I can't beat them prices.
Yes, shit.
I think I know how to make.
I'm running a business here.
I know how to make 100 million. How many 1 penny do I need to get to make 100 million?
Probably 100 million.
Fuck me. That's a lot of lemonade.
Yeah, I don't have that much. I do Dr. Pepper as well. Anyone like Iron Brew?
Yeah, I love Iron Brew.
I've got 2 bottles of that.
Okay, we'll just have lemonade though.
Don't speak for me, you twat.
Hey, I'm...
You should have got me lotto numbers, said you were out busy being paedophile at school.
But I didn't, did I? I was busy, you said.
The only numbers he got was little Stacey's.
Didn't have time for your numbers.
You were outside the school screaming, my name's Ryan Locke and I'm paedophile. Fucking weirdo. Why did I even marry you?
Why have you named yourself after that famous paedophile as well?
The one on that podcast.
The world-renowned paedophile, Ryan Locke.
He told me that little kids love lemonade. That's why I started selling it.
That means you're an enabler. You've played a very dirty hand.
You've got the same chain that Cameron Green does. He's another famous paedo.
I've seen that half a tattoo anywhere.
This?
That was the fisted arm.
That's me holding a lemonade.
Will you ever forgive me, beautiful wife?
For what?
Yeah, for what?
Ruining your life.
A beautiful wife? That's not bloody lemonade. You've been having something stronger than lemonade.
You prick.
Shut your bitch.
No, old, I'm young.
You're more bitter than that lemonade you've been flogging.
You look about 96.
Who's your mum? Fucking roasted, mate.
She is.
Come after. What?
She is. Was born in a lab.
Congrats.
She invented me to be the world's top foremost lemonade seller.
Is that why your Sprite sold in test tubes there, boy?
Is yep. that why you're selling it for free?
I'm on a break. Even when I stop, I can't stop.
You're lemonade selling it book. For free? It's not great.
What runs through your veins?
Lemonade.
Oh, God.
You'd be dead.
Why do you think you have a constant source of lemonade to sell?
Oh, God, he's spunking out his produce.
That's all right. He saw him piss in a bottle and give
not
it
really
to me.
Not really in the mood for a lemonade
probably
anymore.
Shouldn't have drank it.
No, I had too much thirsty.
That generally works. Generally, people are hopping to my lemonade.
Yeah, hopping mad.
Cameron Green will be hopping with his old foot with a bottle opener thing.
Yeah, he is.
Filling the joke there, please, viewers.
And that Ryan Locke will be hopping on his hard drive to break it because he's a paedophile.
He's very unwell in the old noggin, I've heard.
Yes.
That poor man.
Fucking big noggin as well.
So anyway, no lemonade for your toes then.
You're not talking much. Do you need your solicitor to talk for you?
Yeah, yes. Yeah,
No comment.
I plead the fifth.
I pleaded to year fifth.
Fifth birthday.
Year fifth.
Pleaded, please take your pants off.
Oh, fuck me, Ryan.
Your Honour, take me.
Wife of mine, I think we should leave. I don't like this shopkeeper and I don't like this.
Oh, just because of what I caught you doing on the CCTV. Yeah, there's no padding in the Harry boat.
I've got a confession. I'm not really a lemonade seller. I'm a secret judge and you're under arrest.
Secret judge?
Oh, no.
What, not that new documentary that's on a...
Yeah, on General Fuhrer. That's me, the secret judge.
Undercover judge.
Undercover
judge. Who admits to being a paedophile.
It was all a clever ruse.
Hold on. I'm the undercover judge. We've got you.
No!
You're still a paedophile. You're still a serious issue.
Oh, no.
You are an undercover paedo, but you're not anymore.
Bang.
All right, God.
Well, there we go. I think we solved that.
Yeah, beautiful that.
Yeah, hopefully.
Moral of the story?
Hot tubs are expensive, man.
Yeah.
Well said.
Moral of the story.
It's time for the final question.
It's the final
question. This one's a little bit weird.
Right.
What's a niche thing that you really enjoy? I can give you my example to start you off.
Okay.
For me, it's when I'm walking through a supermarket and I see an item is in a place it shouldn't be because the customer's clearly gone, oh, I need this, and they swap it. I saw baby food in an alcohol aisle. That was great. some parent just walks in and putting back the baby food and getting a bottle of Jack Daniels.
That's a very distinct choice someone's made.
Yeah, it's like a pair of socks in the bread aisle. Just imagine a kid walking in some buns.
20 quid a pair then.
You got my new loafers.
Nice. Join in, Ryan.
It's very good.
What do I? I love something really neat. So I really enjoy seeing something that's been really well packaged, like post-it notes.
Yeah.
If you had like a stack of post-it notes and they're all like clumped together, they're in like the cellophane.
What, a deck of cards?
Or a deck of cards. Yeah.
That's weird.
Just something that's.
What?
Don't know. Like,
what do you think of a vacuum pack things? Do you know where it's like put in and then it's sucked, so it's really small?
No, that doesn't do it for me.
It's too much for me.
It's got to be in like sections, if that makes sense.
Wow. What about you?
Ooh. I'd dress up in a fat suit and dress like a priest every time I open a Terry's chocolate orange.
That would bring
without
you
fail.
Great satisfaction.
Without fail.
Do you like Terry's chocolate orange?
I eat six a day.
You won't need that fat so much longer.
Oh, what, yeah.
Some real oranges.
Wow, solid, you mate. Fucking changed, man. Solid, you man. Fucking changed.
Smacks one tyre with a hammer and suddenly it's,
oh, I'm a real orange.
I didn't say like that, though, did I?
That's how you say it.
I don't sound
that's
like
how
that.
You say
it's all
everything.
All that protein there in your throat, mate.
Hench protein throat, mate.
Yeah. Shape.
You're quite proteins, aren't you? Anyway, what niche things do you enjoy?
I'm probably told this story before where I put Q-tips up my nose to make myself sneeze.
Thank you for watching Stephen Tries Podcast. I've been joined by Ryan Locke.
Ryan.
Cameron Green.
Hey.
Ryan.
Greeny.
He's off to badminton.
Ryan.
Oh, Lamington.
Ryan.
And Max Smith.
See you later, guys. Thanks for watching.
Ryan. Stay safe. Stay humble.
Ciao.